I'm Adam Beasley, and this is your Miami Herald Dolphins Report. Most times, this would be a recipe for disaster. Lose the turnover battle 2-0, allow 5 sacks, and stall time and again in the red zone. For the Dolphins, it was no sweat, because their defense dominated the second half, allowing just 86 yards and getting a safety on an intentional grounding to thump the Bills 22-9. It was an all-around great game for the Miami Dolphins defense. Kept the Bills out of the end zone, kept the Dolphins in the game in the first half when the offense was floundering, and then Ryan Tannehill got his act together in the second half. 2 touchdown drives, 2 touchdown passes, 1 to Jarvis Landry, 1 to Brandon Gibson. You put it all together, what do you have? 6-4. They're now a game clear of the Bills. They'll probably have them in the rearview mirror at this point. And they've got momentum heading into Denver in 10 days for a huge game. Denver's very tough to beat up there. And the Dolphins have a shot to really make some noise now in this AFC playoff hunt. They have to play better, though. Mike Wallace afterwards was not happy with the way they played. Say if they play this way, they're not going to really make the playoffs because they're leaving too many points on the field. Ryan Tannehill agreed. It was kind of a subdued locker room. It wasn't joyous, you'd think, after beating a team, after losing them 3 straight times, particularly beating them going away. I mean, this was a pretty good beating in the second half. You'd see a much happier locker room. It was, as I said, subdued. It was sober. And I think they understand that they still need to play better on offense. But the defense, it's playing at a championship level right now. Top 5 in all kinds of statistical categories, and they did nothing but improve it tonight. So that's the story from here. Again, 10 days off for the Dolphins. Go to Denver next weekend, play Peyton Manning. Should be fun.